efficiency is always key when you want to race a solar car.
I mean, it was the first victory for us as a club.
And how far we can actually go with today's technology.
We understood that reliability is really key for solar cars.
It brought us so much closer together in those stressful situations.
It is still a solar car that we built, so always anything can happen with those cars.
So between the European Solar Challenge and the Italian Solar Challenge, we had next to no time to recover from all the rain. We were able to dry ourselves, dry our tents, packed everything and went to Stuttgart. Stuttgart is right on the way between Aachen and Italy, so we took a break there, all of us living at my parents' place for 3 days, because we got the opportunity to visit Mercedes. We benefited a lot from the Mercedes EQXX department, which showed us their development departments, as well as the ideas of their EQXX vision car. It was cool to interact with such knowledgeable engineers there. And once we were done with that, we were off to Imola.
We arrived in Imola after driving the entire day from Stuttgart, from Lina's parents, down to Imola in Italy. And we just set up our tents and then got ready for the next day, because on Monday already we had the scrutineering at the racetrack. Then on Tuesday we had the tech talk and a track walk, so that was the first time we were actually allowed to go on the racetrack in Imola. On Wednesday, then we had a lot of testing during the day, and in the evening or late afternoon, we had the qualifying against the other solar teams. On Thursday, we had the race, so we had to get up really early in the morning, and we had 2 matches of 4 hours, and in between we had a break of 2 hours to charge our solar car. The Italian Solar Challenge actually had a lot of challenges and difficulties for us. One of the big challenges was that it was the first time that the Italian Solar Challenge actually took place, so we had no data about how this race would go and what was maybe some difficulties other teams had in the past years.
It was an entirely new racetrack for us, usually used by the Formula One. With extremely steep inclines, so very, very interesting and new for us. In addition, we were only allowed to charge our battery using solar energy, which happened to be easier in Italy when the sun is shining than in Belgium when it is raining. But we needed to generate that energy, and in the essence, that's what our cars are built for.
And one big thing was the tech talk. We never did a tech talk where we could talk that deeply about technical topics about the Corrector Photon, which was really nice but also really challenging, because we really had to get as deep as possible and still made everything clear and easy to understand from someone who wasn't working on the Corrector Photon for 2 years as we did.
We were allowed to talk for 15 minutes in confidence with engineers from Italian companies.
They knew a lot about racing and of course how those cars work, but also it was nice because the art of building a solar car is really different than building just a race car. And in the end we got some great feedback, and one of the race engineers even said that he now understands why it's so important to do solar racing and why we build solar cars. Just to always push the maximum efficiency and how far we can actually go with today's technology. And at last, of course, it is still a solar car that we built. So always anything can happen with those cars. And this time it also did.
Preparations for this race were a lot more focused on preparing the drivers for the track, because this is an actual Formula One track we've never been to. And this track in Imola is a lot more challenging. The corners are faster and the track itself is a lot more steep. The drivers had a few meetings beforehand and discussed the ideal driving line and discussed the maximum corner speeds. And after the discussions, we had some free practice on the track. On the first driver, in the first stint, we already drove down one tire completely, so we noticed we have to take the corners a lot more slowly if we want to survive the race on one set of tires. The qualifying in Italy consists of just 1 hour on the track, and it's all about the fastest lap time. From free practice we knew we could really do fast lap times on the track, but at the cost of really high tire wear, so we were taking it a little bit slower in qualifying. Our strategy was to do a fast lap in the beginning, take the lead and see what the other teams are doing, and then drive a little bit more relaxed after that to spare our tires. But obviously Solaris was doing the opposite strategy. They were driving relaxed in the beginning and trying for their fastest lap right at the end when there was no time for other teams to react to their fastest lap.
And we needed to overtake them in the last lap of the entire hour. So our driver Tobias had to stay really calm, and he couldn't only overtake Solaris, but he also overtook Solis at the same time.
The race start in Italy was extremely calm. The Covestro Photon was prepared. We were ready to go, and then we started with a flying start, which you might have seen in Formula One, is where all the cars go once around the track before the race actually starts. We were in first position thanks to Toby's performance in qualifying. We just drove for 2 hours, changed driver, and then continued on in first position during the second stint.
After the first 4 hours of racing, we finally had our 2 hour break. And in those 2 hours, we were allowed to charge our solar car just by the sun. So what we had to do is we had to align the solar lid as good as possible to the angle of the sun. As I said, you'd never want to have a shadow on the solar ray because the power can drop by up to 50%. So if you want to change the tires of the solar car, for example, which we did in those 2 hours break, then you have to roll around on the ground to never get any shadow on the solar lid, because then only you can generate as much energy as possible.
During the second part of the race, we had our first real technical problems. The car just wouldn't start, and we had no idea what was going on, so we pushed the car back to our box and tried to fix the problem. Luckily, the electrical department found the problem pretty quick and had spare parts prepared. So a quick board computer swap did the trick, and we were back on the track. The repair was so quick that we never lost first position.
And to Sonnenfunken Team!
Winning in Italy meant that we got our second trophy within the month, and I think that was an amazing experience for every single one in our team, though with many exhausting situations as well. It brought us so much closer together in those stressful situations as well, those very, very joyous situations, and the emotional roller coaster of all of it. So I think in the end everyone deserved the 3 days of break in Como, recharging their batteries to get ready to build the Sonnenwagen 4.
If you've been at races for the past 3 weeks, everybody from the team really knows each other, and now really just a lot of friends building the next solar car. So that is also what those race events are about. It's just to get to know each other and to see how a solar car can perform and how it should perform. So the next Sonnenwagen 4 will be even better, and then we can go to the World Solar Challenge and we'll be prepared as good as possible.